Good morning to everyone. Last session we have completed till sum number 20. Today's session we are going to do sum number 21 and 22. If we read the question, from the following receipts and payment account of AirCard Youth Association, prepare income and expenditure account for the year ended 31st March 2019 and balance sheet as on that date. So details are given. Additional information while reading the question, look at while preparing income and expenditure account, we have to follow some norms. That means while preparing income and expenditure account, no opening balance and closing balance will be appearing. Then only revenue transaction alone will be recorded. That means that the receipts and expenditure which are recurring in nature, that are called revenue transaction. The transaction which are non-recurring in nature, these are called capital transaction. So capital transaction never appear under income and expenditure account. Then only current year subscription alone will be recorded. Previous year, next year subscription will not be recorded. Then non-cash items such as depreciation, outstanding, prepaid expenses will be shown in income and expenditure account. So before start doing the answer, just recall the norms of income and expenditure account. So look at the first one, balance BD won't appear and in income and expenditure account. Government grants for purchases of books. So it's a capital receipt. Won't be appearing under income and expenditure account. So omit it. Subscription 24,800, current year subscription. So it is an income credit side. Admission fees we have received. So it is recurring in nature, credit side. Prize fund receipts. So already we have seen if any amount related to fund, prize fund, match fund, tournament fund. So this will be shown under balance sheet liability side. So omit while preparing income and expenditure account. Bank interest. We are receiving bank interest every month or hotel events or off-hill events. It's recurring in nature. So revenue transaction. So it is an income credit side. Sale of newspaper also. It is recurring in nature, revenue transaction, credit side, income side. Move on to payments, that means salary, it is a revenue transaction, revenue expenditure, so debit side. Office expenses, it's a revenue transaction, revenue expenditure, debit side. Books purchased, it is an asset, it is not non-recurring in nature, it is a capital transaction. So, need not be recorded in income and expenditure account. Then, by stationery purchased. Already we have learnt in sum number 14 and 15 somewhere. So, while writing stationery purchased, look at the additional information. Is there any opening stationery? Yes, it is given. Opening stationery of 1-4. Opening stock, opening stationery plus purchases minus closing stationery. So this formula will be used while entering stationery purchased under debit side, that means expenditure side. We have to use that formula. Then newspaper purchased, it is a revenue transaction, so it appears under debit side, expenditure side. Prizes award, prize fund receipt 6000, prizes award. So these two items will be shown while preparing balance sheet liability side. Then balance carried down, closing balance won't appear in income and expenditure account. Look at the additional information, opening capital fund. So this amount will be shown balance sheet liability side. Stock of books, that means opening stock of books, it is an asset. Opening value of asset, books value 9200. Subscription due not received. So current year subscription already we have received 24,800. Related to this year subscription not yet received. So this amount will be added while writing subscription under income side. Then fourth adjustment, stock of stationery on 1-4-2018. stock of stationery on 31st 3 2019, that means opening stock and closing stock. So this will be shown while writing stationery purchased under expenditure side. Opening stock plus purchases minus closing stationery. This formula will be used. Let me see how to do the answer. By the heading in the books of Yerkard Youth Association, income and expenditure account for the year ended 31st March 2019. Create expenditure and income side, debit side, credit side. So first you enter under expenditure side. First one. So you have to look at in the question under payment side. So all the payments item used to appear under debit side, that means expenditure side. So, to salary 14,000. While writing these expenses, look at the adjustment. Is there any adjustment is given related to this item? We should do the adjustment. Okay. Then next one, to office expenses. It is recurring in nature. So, revenue transaction 7,200. Look at the question. Books purchased. Already I told you it is an asset. So, asset means capital transaction, capital expenditure. So, it will not be shown in income, this side, that means expenditure side. Then move on to next one in the book question, stationery purchased. So, use the formula. What we have done in while preparing sum number 14, 15 and 16, we have used one formula, no? Opening stationery plus purchases minus closing stock. Here, look at the adjustment. Opening stationery value, how much it is given? 1,200. Then look at under payment side, stationery purchase 1,800. Add these two amount, 3,000. Then from the adjustment, closing stock of stationery 2,000. So 3,000 minus 2,000, bring the remaining amount outer column 1,000. Now move on to the question under payment side, newspaper purchased. This revenue transaction, revenue expenditure, so 2,100 debit side. So, all the items which is given under payment side, we have recorded, we have selected one and only revenue expenditure. Now, move on to income side. In the question, look at receipt side. First one, balance BD, it will not be recorded. Move on to next item, government grants for purchases of book. So, it is non-recurring in nature. So, it is a capital receipt. It won't appear in income and expenditure account. Omit first item and second item. Move on to subscription. Third one, by subscription received. That means current year subscription. So far, we have received 24,800. Now, look at the adjustment. Current year subscription is outstanding. How much? 1,700. It to be received. So, add these two amount. So, bring the amount outer column, 26,500. Now, look at the question. Next one is admission fees received, recurring in nature. So, by admission fees, 2,000. Prize fund received, already we have told you. Prize fund, price expenses will be shown in balance sheet. So, omit that item. Then, next one is bank interest. Recurring in nature, revenue transaction, 1,500. Sale of newspaper, it is an income, recurring revenue receipt, show it under credit side, 1,100. So, we have segregated all the items, income and expenditure, we have done along with these adjustments. Now, totally, credit side, if we add all these four items, we got credit side, that means income side total, 31,100. Now, move on to debit side, if we add all these four items, 14,000, 7,200 plus 1,000 plus 2,100 debit side, that means expenditure side total 24,300. So, which side is higher? Credit side. So, write the highest amount both the side total in the same line, 31,100 and 31,100 debit side as well as credit side. Now, deduct these two sides, the difference between debit side and credit side. We got 6,800. So, income is more than the expenditure. So, surplus. That answer will be written as surplus. Balancing figure, surplus, we got 6,800. Clear? Now we have to prepare balance sheet. So this surplus will be forwarded to balance sheet under liability side along with capital. If it is a surplus, to be added with capital. If we meet any deficit, it should be deducted from capital account. Write the heading balance sheet of Ekad Youth Association as on 31st March 2019. Create asset side and liability side. Now, look at the question. Asset side, stock of books, that means opening stock of books. Assets, what are the assets we had in the year beginning? Again, will be brought while preparing balance sheet. Year end, opening stock of books, 9,200 we had in the year beginning. Again, look at the question under payment side. We have purchased goods. Already I have told to you, it is an asset. So add these amount, 15,000 plus 9,200. So year end, books value shows asset. Book value shows 24,200. Then look at the next one. Closing value of cash in hand. Year end, cash value shows 9,900. Then adjustment, subscription outstanding for the current year. So current year subscription still outstanding, we are going to receive. So it is an asset 1,700. And then adjustment, last one, closing stock of stationery. Year end closing stock of stationery shows 2,000. Then move on to liability side. Capital, just recall the formula, capital add surplus. If it is deficit, we have to capital less deficit. Now in this sum, capital fund, look at the adjustment. Opening capital fund shows 20,000. The previous day we got surplus 6,800. So add these two amount, 26,800. In the question under receipt side, we got government grants from for purchases of books. That means 10,000 capital receipt that will be shown here. Then price fund receipt. Price fund receipt, we have received 6,000. From this 6,000, we have price awarded. We spend money 5,000. So 6,000 minus 5,000, bring the amount outer column 1,000. So now totally all the three items, if we total, we got 37,800. At the same time, asset side also, we got 37,800. Balance sheet got balanced. Clear? Now, move on to next question. Sum number 22. Following is the receipts and payment account of Neyveli Science Club for the year ended 31st December 2018. Receipt side and payment side details are given. Balance brought down, carried down. These two items won't appear in income and expenditure account. Whereas while preparing balance sheet, closing balance will be shown under asset side. Just recall the norms of income and expenditure account. No opening and closing balance. Only current year transaction alone. That means current year transaction alone will be recorded. Only revenue transaction alone recorded. Capital transaction not be recorded. The non-cash items also used to appear in income and expenditure account. Just read it. While preparing, first step is we have to prepare income and expenditure account. Then balance sheet. So balance BD, it won't appear. Subscription. Subscription, we have received 8,700. And then subscription includes 600 for the year 2019. That means next year subscription 600 rupees is included in this amount. So that amount should be deducted. While writing each and every income and expenditure, look at the adjustment. If any adjustment is given related to this item, should be adjusted. Life membership fees, it is a capital receipt. so it won't appear in income and expenditure account. Exhibition fund receipt, already I have told to you, if there are any fund receipt, fund expenses will be shown in balance sheet liability side. Sale of science equipment, so usually book value shows 5000, but actually we sold this 5000 value of equipment for 6000. So during this transaction we made profit 1000 rupees. It is an income for us, so take the difference between book value and sale value. 1000 rupees will be recorded under income side. Miscellaneous income, it is a revenue transaction, so income side, credit side. So now opening balance, so omit this one. Postage expenses, it is a revenue transaction, debit sign. Science equipment purchased, it is an asset. Books, equipments, it is an asset, so it won't record under income and expenditure account. Laboratory expenses, debit sign, it is a revenue transaction. Secretary honorarium, it is a revenue expenses, debit sign. Audit fees, revenue transaction, debit sign. General charges, revenue transaction, debit sign. Exhibition expenses, exhibition fund, we received 7000. So from 7000 we made expenses for 5000. So this fund received and exhibition fund expenses will be shown in balance sheet liability side. Then closing balance will be shown in while preparing balance sheet asset side. Clear? Then look at the adjustment, opening capital fund, balance sheet liability side. Subscription includes 600, it appears twice, once in income and expenditure account, should be subtracted from how much we have received, 8700 minus 600. Again, this amount appears under liability side, subscription received in advance. Next year subscription, now itself we have received, so it is a liability. Science equipment, it is an asset, so show it under asset side. Surplus on account of exhibition should be kept in reserve for new auditorium. Prepare income and expenditure account for the year ended 31st December 2018 and balance sheet as on that date. So let me see how to prepare the answer for this sum. Write the heading in the books of Neyveli Science Club, income and expenditure account for the year ended 31st December 2018. Create column, expenditure and income side, debit side and credit side. Now look at the payment side. First one, postage expenses, so recurring in nature, revenue transaction. Laboratory expenses, look at the payment side in your question. Balance BD, that means bank overdraft, won't appear. Postage expenses 200. Then third one, science equipment purchase, it is an asset, so it is a capital transaction, won't appear here. Laboratory expenses 2400. Secretary's honorarium 5000. Audit fees, recurring in nature, revenue transaction 3600. To general charges, revenue transaction, so 1800. Then exhibition expenses, it will be shown while preparing balance sheet. Then move on to income side. In your question, look at receipt side. First one, to balance BD, cash in hand, no opening balance, so omit that one. Next one, subscription. So current year subscription, so far we have received 8700. Look at the adjustment. Subscription received in advance, that means next year subscription, now itself we have received. So this 600 is not related to this year amount. So deduct this. Bring the amount outer column, 8100. Then look at the question, life membership fees, it is a capital receipt, won't appear here. Exhibition fund, fund, prize fund, match fund, tournament fund, exhibition fund. If it is given like this, it will be shown balance sheet under liability side. So sale of science equipment, book value 5000, we have sold it for 6000, 1000 rupees we have earned income. Show it under credit side. Then miscellaneous income 500. Now totally debit side total, that means expenditure 13000. Now look at debit side, credit side. Add these three items, 8100, 1000 and 500. Credit side, that means income side, 9600. So which side is higher? Expenditure side. So write the highest amount both the side in the same line. That means expenditure amount is higher than the income. So we met deficit. The difference between expenditure and income is deficit 3400. So write it as by deficit balancing figure. Next step, we are going to prepare balance sheet. Balance sheet of Neyveli Science Club as on 31st December 2018. So look at year end. That means balance CD. Look at the question at the payment side. Last item, balance CD, closing value of cash in hand, cash at bank, 200 and 400. Then look at science equipment. In this adjustment, third adjustment, look at that opening value of asset, science equipment, we had 5000. Again, during this year, science equipment purchased, it is an asset. So totally 15,000 asset we had. From this 5000 value of science equipment, we have sold. So 15,000 minus 5000. So the year end equipment, science equipment value shows 10,000. We have entered all the assets. Now move on to liability side. Look at the adjustment. First point, capital fund. Use the formula. Capital, if it is surplus, should be added. If it is deficit, should be subtracted. Previous step, we met deficit. So, capital, opening capital 6,400 less deficit 3,400. Bring the amount 3,000, remaining amount outer column. Then, what are the capital receipts we have omitted while preparing income and expenditure? This will be shown here. Life membership fees 5,000. And then look at the adjustment. Subscription received in advance. That means next year subscription of itself we have received. That is a liability for us. That means for this club. 600. Then what are the items we have omitted while preparing income and expenditure account? Look at the question. Exhibition fund. So exhibition fund we have received 7,000. Out of this 7,000, we met expenses for this exhibition 5,000. So year end remaining amount, exhibition value shows, fund value shows 2,000. Now totally credits, liability side, if we add these all four items, we got 10,600, both asset side and liability side. So both the sides got balanced. Clear? So enter these two answers in your class art notebook. Remaining two sums, we will do it in next session. Thank you.